for wedding poses. One of the things that you'll see a lot is I have a lot of serious faces. I'm going for a little bit more intimate, more passionate. But a lot of times I know you work with bride and grooms and they're just not comfortable with those serious faces. So I have a few tricks on how to make it look more natural. First of all, a lot of times with somebody, when you tell them to be serious, they get really tight-lipped and tight-jawed. So what it comes across is, you know, really it looks kind of stressed, it looks kind of angry. So what I always tell people to do first is to relax their jaw. Many people actually bite down and it will flex the jaw muscles. So as soon as they relax those muscles, it makes their face look more relaxed and more slender. So that's one of the first things I say. Secondly, I tell people to keep their lips loose. But when you say that, some people let their jaw just kind of fall open. So one of the tips I give everybody is to breathe in a big deep breath, and then however it feels at the end of the breath, just that natural feeling when you breathe out, that's how your lips should feel in a more serious shot. So you breathe in, and then at the end of the breath, how your lips feel. So tell the bride and groom this. Tell them to practice. Even before the wedding day, tell them, practice a few serious shots. Try that. See what they're most comfortable with. It'll just get them more prepared for those serious, more romantic shots on the big day. When you're posing your bride and groom, really pay attention to the hands. People also show a lot of tension in their hands, and often hands are pretty large, especially compared to the size of the face. So if they are, you know, really kind of clenched, or there's tension, or they're digging into one another, you'll notice. It's something that'll catch the eye, and it's very distracting. They're also very pale, so in a lot of images, they really just catch the eye. So a lot of times, I'll have the couple wiggle their fingers. If they're holding on to somebody's arm, I'll just tell them, hold on a little more softly, or just place the hand on the arm. I'm making sure that they're not digging in. I'm making sure it's not straight joints, just soft. If the palm or the back of the hand is faced directly at the camera, if it looks too big, if it looks a little bit too distracting, rotate the hand so you're seeing more the side and the curve. It's going to be much more flattering for the image. One more thing that you want to look out for, and this is something you'll see that I was very aware of in the PopPhoto posing guide, is where the eyes are of the subject. So there's several pictures that have them posed together and they're looking at each other. But if you have somebody side by side actually looking at each other, all you'll see in the image are the whites of the eyes, and it looks kind of creepy. A lot of times if I have somebody looking left or right, I don't tell them, look left, because if you look, all you see are the whites of my eyes. Instead, I'll give them something to look at. I'll hold my hand up, give them a place to look. So instead of looking all the way left, I'll look maybe over there. So I'm still looking left, but you don't just see the whites of the eyes. So if I have a couple looking at one another, I make sure it's just not pure whites of the eyes or pure profile. A lot of times I'll pose them so it's three quarters or maybe profile, but the eye is not completely to the left or to the right.